Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Thou art the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me after thy will while I am waiting, yielded and still. From Ecclesiastes chapter 2, beginning in verse 17. Therefore I hated life, because the work that is wrought under the sun is grievous unto me. For all is vanity and vexation of spirit. Yea, I hated all my labor, because I had taken under the sun, which I had taken under the sun, because I should leave it unto the man that shall be after me. And who knoweth whether he shall be a wise man or a fool? Yet shall he have rule over all my labor, wherein I have labored, and wherein I have showed myself wise under the sun. This is also vanity. Therefore I went about to cause my heart to despair of all the labor which I took under the sun. For there is a man whose labor is in wisdom, and in knowledge, and in equity. Yet a man that hath not labored therein, shall he leave it for his portion? This also is vanity and a great evil. For what hath man of all his labor, and of the vexation of his heart, wherein he hath labored under the sun? For all his days are sorrows, and his travail grief. Yea, his heart taketh not rest in the night. This is also vanity. There is nothing better for a man than that he should eat and drink, and that he should make his soul enjoy good in his labor. This also I saw, that it was from the hand of God. For who can eat, or who else can hasten hereunto more than I? For God giveth to a man that is good in his sight, wisdom and knowledge and joy, but to the sinner he giveth travail, to gather and to heap up, that he may give to him that is good before God. This also is vanity and vexation of spirit. So the writer of Ecclesiastes is called by some to be the existentialist of the Old Testament. He sees through the absurdity and the meaninglessness of life, and he talks about how if I work hard and I enjoy the fruit of my labor, when I die there's still going to be some fruit left over for somebody that didn't work at all, not to gain what I have left. And so it seems like vanity, and if people labor with a sense of equity, with justice, and do right, you know, and give to others and so on, and treat others fairly, they will do it with joy. God will reward those who trust in him. But even then, it seems like even though the man who works, who labors in God is dealing with some absurdities in life. What sense does it all make, basically? Life is strange. The ultimate absurd existential thing was when Abraham was asked by God to take Isaac up on the hill. He had waited 90-odd years to get this son of the promise. And now God asks him to sacrifice that one thing that he loved the most. It's absolute absurdity. Of course, God did put a ram in the bush and did not require Abraham in the very end to do it. But then God himself gave his son. Hanging there on that cross, the only truly innocent man who ever lived was killed. It doesn't make sense. But Sunday morning, it all comes to fruition. He got up. So that this book of Ecclesiastes is fulfilled in the cross. But Ecclesiastes, this doesn't really give us a hint about the resurrection the way a lot of other parts of the Old Testament do. but for sure, to trust in the Lord, even in this passage we read today, the man is rewarded with joy and wisdom and knowledge who trusts in the Lord and who obeys him and works within him. Paul said that God had foreordained the good works that we should walk in. He didn't say foreordain the exact good works we ought to do, because then he wouldn't leave us the freedom to trust him and we'd be too busy figuring out exactly in detail what God wants in our heads. But he wants us to follow him in a trusting way according to his own inner guidance in our hearts. It's a strange life, but only those who trust in the Lord have hope. Hope is not intellectual, logical sense. Hope is a gift from God to know that things will always get better when they get worse. God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. McDowell. Now let's give this to the kids.
Film Foundation grants film wishes to children who have serious or life-threatening medical conditions. We're teamed up with an awesome organization, New Alternatives for Children, and we have the pleasure of working with these 10 amazing participants. And they're creating all these different stories, and they're really, you know, sharing all about themselves. And that's one of the best things about this program. We actually get to see these participants share their lives with us on film. And the best thing about it is watching them as they get empowered to share their story and to create. And we're just having an amazing time. It's awesome to be in New York City, and it's great to be teamed up with this amazing organization. We're really, really grateful. So thank you. Thank you, New Alternatives. Make some films!